Hello, everybody. My name is Jeremiah. I'm working in the SAP product development in Bardorf, and I'm going to talk today about the intelligent role provisioning and integrated hire-to-retire processes in the Intelligent Enterprise Suite. What we will cover today is that I will give you a brief introduction about how the hire-to-retire scenario looks like as it is shipped with SAP Intelligent Enterprise Suite 2011, then we will have a short look in which scenarios we support, and we'll finally spend the most of the time in the configuration and setup so that you can learn how you can configure that for your company with the least possible effort. We will continue then with a system demo, showing it to you live in the system how the whole process from onboarding to provisioning of roles in the respective target system will happen, and we'll conclude with some additional information for that one. So let's first have a look what those intelligent role provisioning processes are. As you have seen also in other presentations in the track already, SAP is reinventing itself when it comes to the Intelligent Enterprise Suite by shipping four important end-to-end processes that span over multiple processes, and those also span across multiple systems. So if we, for instance, look into this recruit to retire process, we have different systems like an S4 system, like an success factors, like a field class in there. And all of those integrated processes come fully pre-configured, aligned, and have the additional benefit that certain seat qualities, like for instance, a consistent security and identity management, are an integral part of it. And this makes those scenarios so powerful and so much advanced of what the competition has to offer there. If you look now a little bit deeper into this intelligent enterprise process of recruit to retire, you will see that we have the following business applications included there. We have the success factors and the field class. We have Concur and S4HANA, and we have the SAP identity management. All of that runs then on top of the business process platform. And what we want to do there is basically to support all aspects of your workforce. And when it comes to onboarding of employees, when it comes to onboarding of external workers, of certain events in the employee lifecycle, like changing position, like making a global assignment, or finally maybe also doing a position move within the own company or to another company, all of those has certain events that needs to be supported when it comes to a compliant role provisioning, that you always have the roles that you need for the job that you're currently executing within your company. And if we have a further look down, now let's have a look why this is so difficult or has been so difficult in the past. The most important thing, of course, is the sheer complexity of the landscape when it comes to, let's say, the different systems involved and all the roles and processes and authorizations that needs to be supported there. Because in S4HANA, in Concur, in Field Class, and in the success factors applications, we have so many different kinds of authorization models that make it difficult to keep the overview and as well fulfill security needs, making a principle of the least possible access available. And we also have a lot of, let's say, manual processes around when you want to get to your applications. So in former times, you would have different request processes if you want to connect and get a user on an S4HANA instance. And the same is true, obviously, for success factors, for field class, and for Concur and all the other applications. That means the processes, how you get your user, the processes, how you get the roles that you need to do your job, or the groups in Ariba are all different. And this is a very time intensive and cumbersome task to resolve. Whereas where we want to obviously make the progress is that we give you that access, so to say, with just one single action, even automated, and nevertheless still have in mind that you will be able to grant those access in a very compliant manner. And we will also make sure that while you work in multiple systems to perform your job, you will still be compliant and do not impose any further segregation of due to risk for your users. There's a big effort that we have put into automating this process so that the majority of the events that we have in the workforce life, like an onboarding, like changing positions or retiring in the end from the company, is something which runs fully automatically and does not involve manual interactions of the user anymore. And we will show you in the next couple of slides what needs to be done, especially in the configuration section of the whole scenario, so that you can ease the setup and repeat this exercise for yourself, reducing then the time for onboarding all of the 10,000 employees that will have lifecycle events during their time at the company. So what we envision there is a fully automated user lifecycle across your career. And we really talk about a lot of automation here, that we do have support when you get provisioned to systems, and that you will get also the correct roles assigned to you at the moment in time when you onboard the company for the very first day. Whenever you progress in your career within the company, we will have position changes, or you get more responsibility and get promoted, which comes also with different authorizations in the business systems. And we will automatically take care that your entitlements in the whole landscape would follow and progress with your path within the company. From time to time, you will also see that the IT landscape of your company changes drastically with getting new systems on board. And here as well, we will have a fully automated setup that you will get a user in those system without requesting it one by one all the time. And of course, once you once decide to leave the company to maybe look for another job outside, or if you have to retire, then we will also have compliant offboarding events that make sure, and it's the last day in your company, also all the roles and user access to systems will be removed at the same day when you leave. And thus also do not leave any security hole available for the company in that case of event. All of that, as I said, will be simplified. It will be monitored because you also provide a monitoring environment forward. And the administration, as it is set up automatically, will ease also the pain for the IT department to handle and get this process under control for the next couple of years. Good. So let's briefly have an overview which of those HR integration scenarios or HR events we can support currently with the version that we shipped with 2011. So first of all, there is, of course, hiring and onboarding. It means a typical event when you brought on board as a new employee. When you start and enter the company, you get your badge. And when you want to access the systems, we will have all the systems enabled for you. And we will also have the roles assigned to you already in all the different systems. Position change is something I mentioned already earlier. When you change your position within the company, you get promoted or moved to another department. The perfect roles that you need for your new jobs will be added to your profile, and the old roles that you do not longer need will also be removed automatically from your user profile, and you will not have to care for that at all. Offboarding and retiring is also an event that is typically in professional life. As I said, at this point in time, when you offboard or retire, we will remove all your system access, including all the roles from your user, and leaves no mess behind. The same works not only for ordinary employees, but also for contingent workers, where we also handle those events where contingent workers are onboarded to a company only for a limited period of time, and we will later on also remove those user rights from the system once the external worker leaves the company. There are other HR events that are also of importance, especially if you work in international companies. There are something like a global assignment when you are for maybe 1, 2, or 3 years move to another subsidiary somewhere abroad and will get new users and new roles in the subsidiary. You see this corresponding company code and other authorization settings that you need for that work, which will move automatically with you. And once you return back to your normal home country and home assignment, then we will automatically give you the roles you had if you rejoin the same position that you had before. Also, this is something where you don't have to care for it anymore in the future. And there's also, let's say, the concurrent employment, which means that you have maybe multiple working contracts within the same company, which is also a typical thing, that with a flexible workforce that you could have multiple contracts in parallel. And also here we do support all the events that you need to get the users assigned and unassigned with the correct roles all over the time. So let's now spend the majority of the time to have a deeper look into what is needed in the configuration and setup phase to have those automation made possible for you. Let's first have a little look into the overview of how the things would basically look like. We have a so-called HR-driven lifecycle management, where the events in the HR system basically trigger all the rest. So in our scenario here, where we have the HR lifecycle from onboarding to retirement, the following systems are involved there. We have the success factor systems, which basically triggers us and gives us the notification that something happened in the life cycle of an employee. It might be a job change or global assignment or termination. Those events will be captured in a software component that we call the SAP Cloud Identity Access Governance. This is a solution that we have developed on the SAP Cloud Platform. They are based on those HR triggers, automatically access requests are generated, will be sent, depending on your configuration, to your manager for approval. And those after approval will automatically lead to provisioning actions in all the target systems. And on the right-hand side, you can see target systems that we currently support here, meaning that whatever the scenario and the job requires from you, and you need maybe a changed role in the S/4HANA system or in Ariba, or even maybe a user in Microsoft Azure or in the identification servers, all those things will be automatically set and created for you out of the single event that somebody in the HR department changed your job for you. So let's now have a little bit deeper look into the different things and how it behaves. Let's now have a look at the first part. Now, what is happening in the success factor system and then in the cloud identity access governance to process the event? So whenever you basically have an HR event in success factors and you save it, we put an HR event into the event queue of success factor systems, and then we will have a synchronization job, which is run regularly every couple of minutes in the identity access governance solution, which pulls out those HR events out of the success factor system for further processing within the SAP Cloud Platform. We have then set up business rules, which have all the information which system access should be granted or revoked based on the HR event in the success factor system. So those business rules, and we will have a further look in the demo, then will basically decide if you keep your roles, if your the role, additional roles get provisioned to you, or if those roles that you do no longer need for your job get deprovisioned from your user profile. And finally, once this role evaluation is performed, we will eventually then generate an access request workflow in the SAP Cloud Identity Access Governance solution. And this will be sent for approval to either a manager or somebody in the IT security or a role owner. This all depends on the configuration. So what needs to be done to enable that one when we have SAP SuccessFactors as a source system? First of all, we need to connect the SAP Cloud Platform, because the IAG solution is based on that one, to the SAP SuccessFactors employee central destination. Then we will add also the SuccessFactors in the Cloud Identity Access Governance solution as a system. We would later on set up the business rules in the SAP Cloud Platform business rules service. Then we will sync the repository data in SAP Cloud Identity Access Governance. And then we'll later on trigger access requests, which we can proceed further. In the business rule setup phase, meaning after we have called the HR events, we have the different steps. I mean, in the SAP Cloud Platform cockpit, we need to create destinations to the SuccessFactors tenant and sync the user data. Then we will use the editor of the SAP Cloud Platform Business Rule Service to define the rules to derive from information in SuccessFactors what position is meant, which systems and which roles you need for the respective systems. And then later on in the access request service launchpad of IAG, we will trigger the scopes, job scheduler, which then pulls in all the HR events that have been collected since the last run. Setting up business rules in the SAP Cloud Platform is rather easy. There are basically five steps, and we will have a detailed information on each of the five steps for there. So, in general, you have to define a project in this business rule service where we define the events and the input structures or the information that we get from SAP SuccessFactors there. You will then create a rule service, create a model, and later on deploy the rule service and set it active with that way. So first of all, what you have to do is to define a project. There is a special structure that is pre-delivered by SAP for the HR field changes. And this field basically defines to which extent you can configure the rules that you can later on set with different data. So in this structure, you would basically see fields like a company code, like a department. We find something like a position ID and others. And those will be the input fields basically, which allow you later on that you can create and set up business rules, which derive a system user and a role that you can assign to this user in the target systems. And this is a necessary step that we then basically have the input fields, which is all this user HR fields, and we have the access, the resulting access, which is the output of the rule that we have to use. We create a rule, and there are different options how to set up those rules. One of the commonly used ones is using a decision table where you have all the possible input fields and instruct the system what to do with that one. Once this is done, we build such a decision table where we say what needs to be performed there and how the system will be configured based on the attributes that they have selected as an input to the rule. And finally, you can set the rules itself, where you can say for certain combination of input parameters from SuccessFactors, like for instance here for the business unit, then fill the output field. So you can see, for instance, you need a technical rule, which is called ZRS in the system 325. Or for another business unit, then you need a rule of the same kind, but in a different system. Imagine, for instance, the case that you have multiple ERP systems depending on geography all over the world as a larger corporate. The final last step then, obviously, is to create a rule set, combine all those rules in a rule set. And then in the end, you will basically activate them, and then they should be available for consumption within identity access governance, and you can create the corresponding actions out of it. Decision tables are not the only one which can be used there. The business rule service also offers more advanced modeling capabilities with text rules, but we do not show them here in that session. So I refer to other sessions from the colleagues from the SAP Cloud Platform, how to handle the business rule service in a more sophisticated way. Good. Now, assuming that those rules have been evaluated by the identity access governance solution, in the end, the workflow was sent to the manager for approval. And on, let's say, approving this request, you would then trigger actions fully automatically in the target systems. And the target systems are the business systems which are part of this intelligent enterprise scenario. S4HANA, Fieldglass, Ariba, Concur, and others. And then those users are automatically created, or we add and remove roles from users all across the landscape without any additional action. And the system administrator just has to make sure that there's no exception in this process. And for every HR trigger that we have a corresponding rule available. Good. Now let's basically switch over and show you the things live in a demo, because a good visualization is maybe the best thing that we can do here. What we see now is a view into a SuccessFactors system, and we have an employee, Arvind RV. And this employee will basically the one which will have to undergo a job change because he is assigned to another job now. If you look into the S4HANA system, we see that Arvind is user 17 and currently has two business roles assigned. One for the as an administrator for FITSA, for concurrent accounting, and then there's a second role assigned to him, which he should keep for the future. So he is accounts receivable and payables administrator, and at the same time, you can see he's assigned to the role. You will come to that one later, and he's also assigned to a second one, which you will keep for the future. Now we will change his job, and this will trigger finally the HR event. So we basically set a change date for his job. And once this is done, we will see a screen where we give him another position. And this position is basically the lateral move that he will have to do for that one. So he is now moving to a new position from the 2081 to the 2082. It's this specific date, and this is the information that we want to transfer as a trigger to the identity access governance later on. You can see everything is fine. We save it. And then the necessary HR approval processes inside SuccessFactors will be done. But there's nothing else which you will have to set up in SuccessFactors. You just basically for the workflow in SuccessFactor, give a name to whom you will send it, a short justification why those things need to be done. You can show the workflow participants. So we'll go to Gavin, Claire, and Alex, and then confirm, and the things have finished. Now we have left the SuccessFactors systems are now part back in the SAP Cloud Platform in the business rule service. And this is basically where we now define what should happen with those HR events. And here we set up now a business rule that tells us that we will have an event of a position change for employees. And you can see in such a decision table that for this position 28.1, he had basically the role of a pizza administrator and should now get in the A2 the position of a purchasing manager. Still, back a look into the S4HANA system, nothing has changed so far. So you want to remove that role because you are not longer in this position 81. And now trigger the event that we source in all the HR events from SuccessFactors into IAG. So we start an HR trigger. That we do, we schedule this job for immediate execution and then can have a look what happens in the job log with this HR event. So we look into the job history and we will see that our job GM45 that we have triggered is on the way. We now getting all the information from SuccessFactors, seeing that 4 users have been changed nearby, also our user 17 Avint. And from the business rule, you can see that we should add him a role as a purchasing manager. We will remove the other role of the FISA administrator from him. And we will do not have any other action based on the rules, exactly what we have defined. As a manager, I would now go and get an access request, which has been generated automatically, where I can see that for the move of our vendor to this new position of a purchasing manager, what the system wants to do. We will basically add one role and remove another role from him. I'm, as a manager, fine with it because we do not have any risk. So I can safely submit this request and approve it, as I do not increase any segregation of duty violations within the system. With this approval, we have all the actions done automatically. So I now can go forward and also start the provisioning job, which will be in a normal circumstance, something which is already prepared and runs every couple of minutes. Just for the demo purposes, has now been triggered as a one-time event. And again, we can have a look at the job history and see what happens. So in this S4HANA cloud system, from that request event, we have provisioned this one role for the purchasing manager, and we have deprovisioned and removed the role from Avinda for the FISA administrator. Still a look into the unrefreshed S4HANA system. If we now basically do a refresh and look into the user again, we can see that the FISA role is gone, that the purchasing manager is added, and that the planning and configuration expert role has never been touched at all. So this is basically also what you can see in the change log. What has been done, roles removed and other role added to the system. And this basically ends the demo where you have seen a fully automated process of changing a job position and see the reflecting action fully automated in the S4HANA system. And of course, there could be other systems connected as well. So you could easily see how things can run automatically and you do not have any additional setup effort. The time or the date when Avinda comes and changes the job and she logs on to the S4HANA cloud system, she will see that everything is already in right order, fitting at the day of a job change from department 1 to department 2. Good, after the demo, I want also to point you to additional sources of information that can be useful for your own journey through those intelligent enterprise scenarios. Under the SAP roadmap viewer, you will find all the information that we made available to configure those intelligent enterprise scenarios with the SAP Activate roadmap. It is a great source of information, which also points you to all the single steps one by one for the different phases of the project, from discover, over explore and realize to deploy, so that you have a firsthand and very excellent guidance to set all those what you have seen now into life. In the Activate roadmap, we also provide overall guidance. There's a good procedural setup where you can go through the phase from one to the other, and you will see at one glance all the deliverables and tasks that you have along the way of the roadmap. And there are also instructions and transitions available for you as well as links to the detailed documentation for every single point of all the involved products at the time when you need it on the implementation project. And this is something where we point to additional sources of information. So in the roadmap, you jump to the best practices, you jump to the SAP help portal, to blogs, to OSS notes if needed, to communities, and also to the learning hub when you want to have then for your employees learning content to get familiar with the new solution. As a summary and as an outlook for you, we have three key takeaways for you. The first one is that you have learned that this user lifecycle management in the Intelligent Enterprise Suite can be fully automated and react to HR events. This is what we have seen in the demo. And there's no, let's say, manual effort anymore to coordinate between HR and IT, how you get a user and a role in the special system. The authorizations that you need for the different HR events, like additional roles or access to additional systems, will be derived automatically from the SAP Cloud Platform Business Rules Service based on the information that you get within the HR triggering event, for instance, like a position ID, like a company code, like geographic locations and other attributes. And those can all be processed within rules and derives then finally the desired roles and system access that you would need for proceeding further. And the SAP Cloud Identity Governance solution would then deliver additional compliance functions, like for instance, for I approval workflow and an integrated segregation of duty risk analysis to make sure that even with those automatic HR events, you do not increase the security risk within your company. Finally, also we will provision all those roles and systems through the identity provisioning service triggered from Cloud IAG, and then you will see how systems will be available and roles will be assigned to the user according to the job at the day when you start and need them. You could also find other interesting content from the SAP TechEd in 2020, this time virtual. You could have a look at the Learning Hub as well as you could subscribe there to increase your skills when it comes to SAP solutions. So feel free to participate to make use of all of this great content to ease your professional life when it comes to the implementation of those Intelligent Enterprise Suite scenarios within SAP. Good, and with that one, I would like to thank you very much for attending the session. Have fun configuring it and take advantage of what we basically have pre-thought for you. Thanks very much.
Thank you.